Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for your Commodore Amiga personal computer. I am Amethyst Lunatari, and, well, we've opened this door. Well, first we open this door with the lasers, which you can't see. It's just text. And then we open this door with the special key? No. The key was just to open the other door. This one just opened normally, but then beyond it was rocks, which we blew up. We had to drill a hole and then put the explosive pack inside. Oh! I assume we're in the radioactive area. Someone in the party is being badly injured by the radioactive dust. Badly injured. I'm assuming it would affect vitality. You could be helpful and tell me which person is being badly injured. I don't see anything. I'm even looking here. Oh! It's affecting vitality. It hit Epsilon. Well, Epsilon had 100%. So it gave his mask away because he has 88%. So, now that I know it's affecting vitality, it's affecting vitality. Alright. The only bad thing is, I don't think we can cast a spell on somebody. Only for... in battle. So how do you heal this person? I don't know. Wow. What? Is it real time? I think it's when you move forward. That would make sense. This window should be red, not in everything. Everything is covered here in choking, thick, radioactive red dust. Yeah, even our HUD. So I'm badly injured. Oh, brother. It's just him? He's the only one being hurt? Why? Why is he the only one hurt? Because our radiation resistance is a lot lower for the others. 22%, 27%. Epsilon is, well, supposedly would be enjoying 88%. But he's gonna be dead soon. What if we rest in here? I assume that's not possible. Wait a second. This is not a very suitable place for resting. One of your team members chokes and falls dead onto the ground. Which one? He's dead? Epsilon's dead? Yeah, he is. Wow. And we walk through. It's not... Okay. It's not the radiation resistance, then. It's the mask. He needs the mask. Which is weird, because... It's kind of non-intuitive, because when you put the mask on, the percentage increases. So like, ah, now I'm better suited against radiation. But the game mechanics, I don't think, are reflecting that. You need the mask on. It's an all-or-nothing thing, as far as the game is concerned. But it's not what the stats are showing, man. It's just not. Alright, so as far as who's going to wear this mask, or who's not going to wear the mask, because we only have five of them, so we're back to that original problem. Yeah, no one else is getting hurt at all with the mask on. At least so far. I mean, we didn't go that far. Alright, so who's... As far as vitality... I think Killdozer is the highest. 125. But it's not too much higher than Epsilon. You don't have a way to leave people behind. I mean, if we could break up the party. There were some items there I didn't get a chance to look at, because I was more focused on us not dying. Alright. Well, in any case, we're gonna reload this. To where he's not dead. So we gotta give him a mask then. Oh wait, he has it here, that's right. Okay, so now he's wearing the mask. And Killdozer isn't. And I don't think this value means anything as far as walking through these tunnels. Very likely we'll die again, so let's just save. As a new save. Okay, so. The other option is if we wait here's like metal shadow. Stubble. His metal stubble. That's pretty awesome. If we switch the mask, like, wait until Killdozer, he's the highest in terms of vitality, so wait until his vitality is really down low, then switch the mask to someone else. Like, the second highest is Twin Snake, so Twin Snake will give him his mask, that kind of thing. I hope I didn't miss another mask. I mean, there was a pile of masks. Why would there be a pile of masks and then one mask off by itself, right? Alright. So now we know which party member's being hurt. So here we've got an axe grenade launcher with two ammo. I can't take it. Moonclaw is the one that can't carry anything. Can I drop an item? Like that? See, as long as we don't move, we're not being injured. Where's he at anyway? Oh my god! He's already down to 15? What? Oh, I think if we do that, we drop it on the ground. You can't even use these things. Alright. I know this is cheesy, but we're gonna die walking back, so might as well load the game. We're back here. Get ready for this equipment. Maybe we can just grab it, run back, rest, etc. So we go like this. Will you leave that item on the wasteland? It will be gone forever. Yes. I haven't found anywhere where you can sell anything, so... Yes. Do we have two knives? We do have two knives. Okay, I'm gonna drop that as well. Endurance level? Is this like how much stuff he's carrying? He is holding a lot of stuff. Another knife. I don't want to throw them all away. He's gonna be out of ammo soon. Extra nunchucks. Alright, so... His endurance is 25.63 out of 51. 25.63. Right, okay. So it brings the endurance down. Nunchucks, extra nunchucks. Oh, and it gives you a preview, too, of how... Like, if you want to drop it, it would go down that much. Yeah, I was not going to drop those, don't worry. Light leather boots. Yeah, no one can use these. Well, we have better things than that. I mean, so we can give some stuff to Epsilon. He's got pretty low, 36. And what's with Runeclaw? He can't carry anything. Is it because of his strength or something? I guess 16. Yeah, he's got really low strength. Yeah, he's got low strength, so it makes sense. He can't carry crap. That's all. What do you want from the guy? He doesn't work out. He works on his psi powers and stuff. Alright. So the Epsilon has space. So does Varanus and Advent. Okay. Let's give these things over to Advent. I'm gonna give him... these grenades. It's the grenades that's adding a lot. Now, he might be able to pick that stuff up now. Now that we did all that... Save again. Because this could be another one-way trip. Ta-da-dun-dun-dun! Alright, so now, Axe Grenade Launcher. He's carrying it. That's it? Hey, there are no items. So, that's an Axe Splinter Grenade. And that's regular Axe Grenades. I want to cast a spell on him. I want to cast Alpha Catharsis on him. Movement. Well, we need to switch off. We can get back by swapping the mask out. Hopefully he can pick it up. He's full again. So now he's wearing it. Now Twin Snake gets injured. That's for role-playing purposes. Let's see what we got. So he's at 15 vitality. 6 vitality. They just drop super quick. crazy. But we can rest. Well, we got somewhere. We got a grenade launcher to go with all these grenades. And, hopefully we can make it somewhere. Sorry guys, I'm saving so often because it's very likely someone's gonna die. Past. Wait. My God. All right, he needs the mask now. I'll keep looking at stamina and forgetting to look at vitality. Yeah, he needs some help. Three. Alright. Let's give him Epsilon's mask. Keep an eye on Epsilon. There's an item over here. A force field generator. Of what use is that? Heavy mining helmet. Who's the one who doesn't have it now? Epsilon, right? Dust filter mask. That's the same one, right? That they have? Yes! Okay, this is our last last chance gas. Our last chance mask. Okay. Just curious where he is. Yeah, his vitality went to 23. Wow. We should go back and rest now that we have all these masks. But first, I would just like to get to know you. Let's analyze the heavy mining helmet. .50 kilograms, speed factor 65%. Only used for knight, mercenary, and assassin. Let me write this down. So it's the three, what do you call it, classes? Melee classes? Fighting classes. Combat, you know. So physical defense, it's not that great, right? Plus 5, but then again, a helmet only gives you a little bit, right? It's only protecting your head. Plus 10, I have to compare it with the other helmets. minus to mental attack. That your mental attack or you being attacked by mental stuff? I don't know. Plus two mental attack plus, oh, minus five. All right, so that's that. Again, yeah, it's plus 8% radiation, so you figure it would help. But the masks are, it's an on-off thing. Which is weird that the game doesn't, yeah, it's like it has these resistances, but I guess they're only for use in combat. Otherwise it's acting like an adventure game, you need the mask or you can't proceed kind of thing. So I'm not even going to look at that. I'm just going to compare the other stats to another helmet. That back there, and oh, Desert Hood. So steel, for example, the steel combat helmet. Let's see how it stacks up against that. Probably not as good because it's just a mining helmet, right? Okay, so the physical defense is the same. Physical protection here is a little better, plus 15%. And range defense is plus 2%, same. But there's no mental attack value. It's really good against extreme sound and pressure. So you have a better helmet, as far as what I can tell. Oh. Well, apparently Killdozer doesn't have any helmet. I don't know why. He just has a desert hood and a mask. Twin Snake has the steel combat helmet. Alright, so I'm gonna give that to Killdozer. So the poor guy actually has a helmet. Good. And then what else do we pick up? A force field generator. I'm going to assume this is another item to be used somewhere like an adventure game type thing, not in combat. That's just what I'm assuming. Let's see if we get anything interesting from this. 4.10 kilograms. It's heavy. It's got some stats. I wonder if you wear the thing. Like it puts a force field around you and helps you. Right. Let me analyze it again. Because I wasn't really paying attention to the stats. I was more thinking that it was an item to use somewhere. So it affects your physical action time in a negative way. Physical defense. It's like really good. I think it's good for... Sorry, I keep looking at this over and over again. I think it's good for all classes, it said? See, when it says all classes, it makes me think that... Yeah, this is not something that you can wear. But maybe it is? Now that we have our masks on, can we rest down here? No. I gotta go back. and do that. So, Can't wear it over this. Looks like over your armor. So if all classes can use it, we're gonna give it to a magic user who can't wear armor like that. Like Runeclaw. He's only wearing a uniform tunic and this amulet. Varanus. Oh, he has combined light armor. That's not too bad then. And Advent. He has combined light armor. Alright, so I'm gonna give this to Runeclaw. I'm assuming he can then wear it. Oh, he can't. His strength is so low that he can't even wear it. That's probably why he's not wearing any armor to begin with. That's sad, isn't it? That is really sad. What happened to the item? Maybe I deselected it. Oh, that's right, I'm still... Oh, because when I tried to give it to him, it just went back. So, Varanus has low vitality and stuff, so give that to him. So he's wearing the force field generator and the combined light armor and a uniform tunic. Alright, let's go back and rest. And no one's getting hurt. Very happy about that. Alright, so... sitting around with 15 vitality, 23, and 3. Now resting. Alright, we should be good now. So we went around that loop-de-loop and we picked up that stuff. So we can skip that and just... I don't even like saving here. Let me just look at something. There's radiation. You gotta give me radiation, don't you? I'm just double checking to make sure my vitality is really good. Okay. My, the time really flies, doesn't it? Well, I didn't make it that far, but at least we figured out. We have masks for everybody. We got some new things. We can go explore next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.